So in this video I'm going to assemble the Elec Maker 2500mW A5 Mini Laser Engraver machine, which was sent to me from GearBest.
Oh, these are cute. Please don't shoot the eye when using must-wear goggles. Okay, so I'm going to assemble this mini laser engraver, and there's no instructions in the actual packaging. In any case, I did a bit of research and found two videos online. One, it sounded like it was in possibly Portuguese, and another one which had really bad music on it. And based on those two, I think I can sort of work out what to do. Pieces are quite thick, they look about 8mm. They've also been cut on a laser cutter, and they have a protective coating on them in the form of this brown paper, which actually looks quite nice. So I'm guessing these are the sides, this is the gantry, this is possibly to hold the controller, and this is the back and front. Okay, so all the fixings are inside this pack lunch box and it's sealed. I was also provided with these, I think they're NEMA 17 motors. I think I'm going to screw these on now. I mean, it's kind of, you just got to use the power of deduction to work out which screws, machine screws, fit on which part of the machine. Obviously there's three stepper motors with four holes each, that means there's 12. There happen to be 12 of these. I think the thing to remember with the motors is to put the contacts facing where the wire should be going. In this case it's towards the rear of the machine. This kit has a very amazing smell to it. I think you can, it's definitely this paper, something about this paper has quite an intense smell. The bolt goes through there, spacer, wheel. Maybe it's the other way around. Yep, bolt goes in this way. Okay, I've done both sides. I think I'm going to probably have to take this bit off to fit the gantry. So, long machine screw, spacer, wheel, spacer. I guess what's interesting about sort of kits like this is you kind of feel like the graphic design has been taken out of the equation, you know, and it really is about just working it out, which actually is quite a nice feeling. I guess everything we do is just so mediated, to just kind of have to figure something out yourself. So I'm going to need to put some nuts into the extrusion so I can hold the belt down. Okay, so there's a lot of tiny nuts. Not sure how. Okay, so I think what you do, timing belt goes through the slot, it's facing down. One of these nuts goes through here, and that tightens it there. I think smaller machine screw goes down like that. It feels quite tight. Okay, so the next thing is feeding this through. Okay, I've stuck the gantry on the wrong way around, so I'm going to undo these bolts and flip it round. While I've got it off, I'm going to put the laser on. I'll just bolt this back on. So make sure you put the laser on first. Okay, so I'm going to attach the electronics now, and this is the driver board with the Arduino. I noticed these red buttons here earlier, and I didn't quite know what they were for, so I guess they probably sit inside here. Okay, so I think these spacers, there's four of them, fit onto the black bit of plastic, and this is going to hold the buttons in place. Then you've got these smaller spacers, which I imagine go okay, the holes line up that way. So like I said, you just have to look at what you're doing and just work it out. I've made a few mistakes as I've gone along, but this is such a simple design. All it means is I just have to undo a couple machine screws and then I'm back on track. So those buttons actually can be pushed into position, so you don't have to balance them like I was doing. So the wires which connect the stepper motors to the driver board are already heat shrinked. You don't really have to do too much here. I'm just putting this wrapping, I'm not sure what it is, around the wires just to protect them and stop them possibly getting lasered. Right, I'm just going to double check that I haven't left anything out. There are some holes up here, I'm not sure what they're for. Maybe a limit switch or something.
So the assembly was straightforward, although I made a few mistakes along the way and had to undo some sections. It roughly took me 2 to 3 hours while filming to make, and the kit looks pretty neat when assembled. The size is good for small decorative projects, and placing the CNC engraver over larger objects. There was a useful weak laser button on the shield, which you could use to focus the beam without damaging the material surface. I was using a free software called Bembox, which seemed to have a lot of settings. It took me a while to figure out how to use it, but there's lots of forums and information online. At first I was not getting any movement, but after selecting the correct firmware for the driver shield under the lightning bolt button, in my case this was the Arduino LX Nano, and changing a few settings, the PPM to 320 and feed rate to 1000, everything seemed to work. Please let me know if you found this video interesting and whether you'd like to see more like this. I think the next thing I'll do is try and engrave something on the back of the oak chopping board that I leveled in the previous video. Anyway, thanks for watching and see you next time.